In today's topic, we're going to deal with something really weird, something really sad, something that doesn't have to be with my channel. My channel usually talks about traveling domestically, traveling internationally, but today, I don't know, I felt like talking about this with you guys. The past week has been a bit weird. We have seen a lot of things, and it came to my mind that usually we don't talk about these kind of things. Like, I don't know whether we avoid to talk about these things or it's just a taboo in our country. I don't know what's wrong with this, but the point is, we as human beings try to avoid talking about these topics. And whatever happened last week was quite shocking. It was something really weird. I'm not trying to jump on a trend or anything, but I just felt like sharing what I feel about these kind of issues and what I feel as a fan of this person that I'm going to talk about today. By now, you might have already guessed who am I talking about, but being one of his biggest fans and really admiring his journey, and I don't know what to say. Actually, I'm in a loss of words right now because it came out of nowhere. You know, came out of nowhere, and I really admired his journey about, you know, chasing your dreams and not going down no matter how much the world tries to pull you. Yes, by now you might have already guessed it. I am definitely talking about Sushant Singh Rajput and whatever happened in the past week. Talking about this actually makes me feel sad, and I really can't believe that someone who was so much successful and someone who was such an inspiration to others could take such a drastic step and end his life. So it's a video about me and what are my thoughts about the whole situation that is going around right now and what I as a fan am going through. I don't want to keep any intro or anything like that. As I talk about this, it is hard for me to even say what am I going through, and I don't know whether I'll be able to keep it in a format where we talk about these kind of issues in a proper way or whatever, but I don't know. And I guess it is okay to say that we all are in a loss of words and we all are shocked with whatever happened in the past week. So please try to bear with me. Please try to just bear with me and all my thoughts and whatever I'm talking about. Now, my channel doesn't usually deal with these kind of things. Everything that was coming in front of us in the past week, like all about depression and all about anxiety and all these kind of things, I usually deal with subjects like traveling and everything related to traveling, but I guess it'll be fair to say that I'm trying to just vaguely try to make a relation about this video, because this video has nothing to do with the topic I deal with, but I can vaguely try to relate it for you guys if you have any interest in that, because it is something weird that we all are facing and it is something that nobody wants to go through. All I want to say is that we usually travel when we are in a good mood, or we usually travel when we want our moods to be good. So yeah, that is the relation between my channel and today's topic of discussion, I guess. Yes, we are going to talk about depression and sensitive issues like these today. And see, as I said, we usually try to travel when we are in a good mood. Never that you are in a bad mood and you just have to travel, because if you're doing that, that's wrong, obviously. But either we travel to make our moods right, positive again, to find the positivity in our life, or we travel just because we are feeling positive that day, we are feeling good that day. So that is all I wanted to say about the topic, if we are trying to find a relation between these two things. But what I'm going to talk about today is completely out of the realms of traveling. Now, talking about Sushant Singh Rajput, he was a brilliant actor, and it won't be a mistake to say that we all knew him from the very beginning. We all knew he was from his old TV serial days. So we have been through his journey and with him, and we have seen what kind of a person he was. We have seen his struggle. We have seen him become become something big, from a TV star to a superstar. And in each step of his way, I guess we all have taken the journey with him. we all have been with him. We all have been in his journey with him. We have seen him grow. We have seen him grow as an actor. We have seen him become mature as a person. And there were a lot of things positive about him. So it literally shakes me to my core that a person filled with so much positivity and filled with so much of knowledge about everything can take such a drastic step. I still remember those days when he was the Manav of Pavitra Rishta, and from there he went through all these dance shows and competitions, and then we knew him as the father of the kid in Chichore, as Anni, and somewhere I could feel that this guy was literally portraying himself as he was in his real life with all that positivity and everything. And it won't be a mistake to say that he was literally growing up in his career graph as from, if we see from where he started. So he was made for greater things. He was made for brilliant things in life. And it was quite weird to see this thing, that how can an industry or how can a pressure of work or anything can make you so upset that you end up taking your life as if it is the only option left for you. There are so many things that we can talk about, like his achievements, his performance from Rai Poche to performance in Chitore. Everything was brilliant, and he was a hard-working actor. We all know that, and it's something that you really can't say that he wasn't a hard-working person, because you could see that dedication in his eyes. You could see that dedication and hard work in his performances. But the problem is, he was never appreciated for his work. He was never appreciated for his performances. He was never appreciated for his dedication or anything. I mean, to be honest, I don't even remember him winning an award for Chitore or winning an award for any other movie that he has done, not even Boni. And there are thousands of videos talking about these things, and there are thousands of videos talking about the way he was being treated, the way he was, you know, pulled off from each and every project, the way he was not invited in parties and all. It's there, it's evident. There are people talking about this. But I don't think that we are looking at another aspect of his journey. We are definitely talking about how Bollywood was treating him. We are definitely talking about how we should boycott these things. And there are literally thousands of videos on these kind of topics, and I'm not here to cover those today. I'm not here to talk about those videos or talk about the issue about Bollywood, because it is something that nobody can really fight with this industry, because the people over there are quite rich, and the people over there know how to use their riches for their benefit. And no matter how many hashtag boycott this and boycott that you trend on Twitter, the fact is, we are going to end up watching one of those, or one of the movies from the same production houses, or one of the movies of the same stars or the star kids that we are definitely talking about boycotting them today. So there is literally no way that we can ban these kind of practices. But what I feel as a person, and we can definitely do, is appreciate these kind of people, appreciate the people who are literally working hard, who are literally making efforts to stay in this industry, to stay relevant in this industry. We can definitely appreciate people like Manoj Bajpayee or Pankaj Tripathi. There is also a video talking about this issue and how can we as consumers of the movie industry and change those practices, and I'll link it down below if you are interested in looking at it. The guy over there talks brilliantly about what we can do as people, or as the customers of this kind of an industry where this kind of practices are there. And he literally tells the same point that I have been talking about, that how we can change the Bollywood industry and how we can support these kind of people who are literally working hard on this, who are literally trying to make a change, and who are not taking their position, whatever they have, for granted. Talking about Sushant Singh Rajput, to be honest, he could have been treated differently. He could have been, I don't know, man, if you even if the Bollywood industry never liked him as a person or whatever might be the case, they could have literally at least they could have literally treated him like a person. Or most of the people who are so-called giving him chances to work in their movies, like big production houses, they only did it because of the bankability of that star, of that person, and the kind of talent he was. And once they were done with it, they didn't care, to be honest. I mean, come on, he was the part of the industry, he was making movies, and he could have literally been invited for the parties, man, let alone the parties. He could, at least, people could have had a talk with him. You know, if you have someone to talk to, things get easier. It becomes easier to survive. And the sad part is, even if the Bollywood industry is so tightly knit, there was nobody for him. There was nobody for him. There was no one when he needed help. There was no one when he wanted to talk to someone. That is the sad reality. And this has made me think about so many things. Things like, are the people that we call friends really our friends? Or are the people we think of as a family, out of our family, are really ours? And to the people who are listening to me right now, I don't know, man. If you think, or if you ever feel sad, ever feel down, ever feel low, or you are on this video just because somehow typed about depression, or just went like, yeah, I feel low, I want to listen to something, or I just want to listen to something motivating or anything, please remember, please, if you ever feel low, if you ever feel like giving up, go talk to your friends, go talk to your family, go talk to them. Trust me, guys, if you have that one person to talk to, things will be easier in life. Giving up life is not an option, guys. It's never an option. Everything has a solution, and everything can be taken over with ample amount of time and dedication. Talk to your friends, the friends that you trust, the friends who have been there for you, and you have seen them. You have seen them taking care of you when you were low. Talk to them. I don't think they will ever tell you that they don't want to talk to you if they are your true friends. And they will literally help you again and again, no matter how many times you fall. You have family as well. Talk to your families. Friends, okay, I understand. Most of the time, people don't want to talk about topics like depression with their friends. But you can definitely talk about this with your family. Family will always be there no matter what. Talk to them. Tell them how you feel. If that doesn't work out, if you still feel low, go take some professional help. No, there is nothing to be frightened about this kind of an issue. It can happen to anyone. Depression is something that can happen to anyone, no matter who you are, how rich and famous you are, or how poor, or whatever you are. Depression can happen to anyone. And trust me, guys, we have an example of that. We have an example of that over here. And the major takeaway from this is that no matter how rich and famous you are, you can be sad, you can be depressed, you can get depressed. And no matter how poor you are, you can still be happy. The major takeaway from this should be that whenever you feel low, talking can help. Seeking help doesn't make you look weak, or it doesn't make you feel guilty of anything. I'll be putting some links down below. You guys can definitely check those out if you are going through this kind of a phase in life, you guys. And if you guys really want some help, I'll be really putting down some links down below to check that out. Some professional help, actually. So trust me, guys, no matter how big the problem might seem, it always has a solution. Giving up is never a solution. Trust me, giving up is never a solution. No matter how many times you fall, you have to get up, fight. Fight for your family, fight for the people that you care about, fight for the people you love, fight for them. I know you can do this. And if you feel like I have made some change in your life, if you feel like I have helped you in some way, or if there is a person who can literally get some help from this video, do share it, do like it, like the video, do like and share and subscribe, as it will help the algorithm. Not only that, it will help my video to reach a lot of people. A lot of people who might be needing help, who might be seeking for some advice, who might be looking for some kind of a help, but they are not being able to talk about this kind of thing. So please do share the video as much as possible. Do like the video, it helps the algorithm. Do subscribe if I have made some kind of a change in your life. And that's it for today, guys. That's it. I know the video has been quite off the topic and everything has been weird, but I think as a person, as a human being, it is necessary for people to talk about this kind of an issue. You need humans to keep up the humanity. That's it for today, guys. It's your random brother. Cheers.